Hello everyone, we will see the fast Fourier transform. First, let's discuss a direct evolution of DFT. We write equation for DFT as x of k is equal to summation n goes from 0 to n minus 1 x of n into e raised to minus j 2 pi nk by n. K is actually greater than or equal to 0, or it is less than or equal to n minus 1. We write actually Wn as e raised to minus j 2 pi by n. And if I substitute this value in this equation, I will get x of k is equal to summation n goes from 0 to n minus 1 x of n into w n n k, where again k will take the value like this. K is greater than or equal to 0 and is less than or equal to n minus 1. This can be further written as imaginary term and a real term, where I can write this term in imaginary and real term, and this W term also in the real and imaginary. And this can be written as summation n goes from 0 to n minus 1, a real part of x of n plus j, imaginary part of x of n, into real part of W n n k plus imaginary part of W n n k, right? This can be written as summation n goes from 0 to n minus 1, real part of x of n into real part of W n n k minus summation n goes from 0 to n minus 1, imaginary part of x of n multiplied by imaginary part of w n n k minus j, and this is a imaginary part, summation n goes from 0 to n minus 1, imaginary part of x of n into real part of w n n k plus summation n goes from 0 to n minus 1, real part of x of n into imaginary part of w n n k. Now here you can see that complex multiplication. Suppose for one, if you want to calculate one term, we need to do n multiplications. From here we can find out that for n terms, we are required to do n square multiplications. And to calculate one term, we need to do n minus 1 additions. So for n terms, we will require n into n minus 1 additions. So this many calculations are required for a direct evaluation of DFT. Now, as you can see that these are too many calculations, so we found out a way, that is a fast Fourier transform. The fast Fourier transform reduces the calculation of complex multiplications from n square to n by 2 log of 2n. That means, suppose let's take an example that n is equal to 1024. In this case, we will require in the direct evaluation, we will require to calculate near about 10 raised to 6 complex multiplication, whereas in FFT we will require only to calculate the complex multiplications of 5000. So this is a reduction of near about 200. So if we'll divide this, you can find that. So there is a reduction, that is the ratio is 200. So that many less the relatively the ratio by which the calculation get reduced are this many for n is equal to 1024. So you can see that the calculations required for FFT are less, and therefore we go for FFT. The first algorithm in FFT is decimation in time algorithm. So this is called as DIT FFT. Let's see how it is being calculated. Now this algorithm, also known as RADx 2 DIT FFT. So this means that the number of output points n can be expressed as in the power of 2, that is n is equal to 2 raised to m, okay, where this m is an integer, right? What we in the first step, what we do is that we assume that by this equation we can say that n is assumed to be in the power of 2. So what we do is that we divide entire sequence in the length of n by 2. We will divide this into the even part and odd part. So entire x of n we will divide in even and odd. X of xe n is equal to x of 2n, where n takes the value of 0, 1, dot 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 n by 2 minus 1, and odd part, that is x of n, is x of 2n plus 1, where n takes a value of 0, 1, dot 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 n by 2 minus 1. Now we know that the DFT, endpoint DFT, is written as x of k is equal to summation n goes from 0 to n minus 1, x of n, w, n, and k. K goes from 0, 1, dot, 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 n minus 1. So if I'll write this in the even and odd part, I can write it as summation n goes from 0 to n minus 1. This is for even. Okay, x of n, w, n, n, k plus summation n goes from 0 to n minus 1, and this I'll write for odd part, that is x of n, w, n, n, k. Now this both term can be rewritten as summation n goes from 0 to n by 2 minus 1, x of 2 n, wn 2nk plus summation n goes from 0 to n by 2 minus 1 x of 2n plus 1 into w 2n plus 1 into k. Now this term I can rewrite as two terms as, so w, so term w n 2 n plus 1 k, this can be written as w n 2 n k into w n k, right? As this part is independent of small n, we can take this in outside of this summation, and I can write this as, so x of k is equal to summation n goes from 0 to n by 2 minus 1 x of 2n w n 2nk plus w n k summation n goes from 0 to n by 2 minus 1 x of 2n plus 1 into w n 2nk. And so these are the even and odd parts, so I can replace them and I can write this as summation n goes from 0 to n by 2 minus 1 x e of n into w n 2nk plus w k summation n goes from 0 to n by 2 minus 1. This is odd, so x o n w n 2nk. Now here w and 2 I can rewrite as e raised to minus j 2 pi by n square, right? And this can be rewritten as e raised to minus 2 j pi divided by n by 2, which I can rewrite as w n by 2. So w n square can be written as w n by 2. Therefore the term x of k will become summation n goes from 0 to n by 2 minus 1 x e of n into w n by 2 n k plus w n k summation n goes from 0 to n by 2 minus 1 x o n w n by 2 n k. So this term is nothing but n by 2 point DFT of even indexed index sequence, and this part is n by 2 point DFT of odd indexed sequence, and I can write this as xe of k plus wnk xo. Now here the w and k is periodic, and therefore w n k plus n by 2 is equal to minus a w n k, and therefore the above equation can be rewritten as x of k is equal to x of e k minus n by 2 minus w n k minus n by 2 x o, that is the odd part of k minus n by 2, and this we are doing for k is greater than n by 2, and therefore k takes the values of n by 2, n by 2 plus 1, dot 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 up to n minus 1. Let's take n is equal to 8 and xe of k and xo of k. Here both of these are 4 point of, why 4 point? Because it is n by 2. So 4 point DFTs of, this is xe k is of even sequence, that is xc of n, and this is of odd sequence, that is xo of n. Xe of 0 is actually x of 0, xc of 1 is actually x of 2, xe of 2 is x of 4, xe of 3 is x of 6. This is even part, and for odd, x of xo of 0 is nothing but x1, xo of 1 is nothing but x3, xo of 2 is nothing but x5, and xo of 3 is nothing but x7. xk is equal to xe of k plus w8k x0k for 0 is less than or equal to k, which is less than or equal to 3, and this is equal to xc of k minus 4 minus w8 k minus 4 x o k minus 4 for, this is for 4 is less than or equal to k, and which is less than or equal to 7, right? So if I will substitute different values of k, what I'm going to get here is x of 0 is xe of 0 plus w81 xo of 0, x of 4 I'm going to get as xe of 0 minus w80 of xo of 0, x1 I'm going to get as xe of 1 plus w81 xo of 1, and x5 is equal to xe of 1 minus w81 xo of 1, x2 I'm going to get as xc of 2 plus w82 xo of 2, x of 6 is equal to xe of 2 minus w82 xo of 2, x3 is equal to xe of 3 plus w83 xo of 3, x7 is equal to xe of 3 minus w83 xo of 3. Here we can see that xo and x4 have same inputs, whereas x1 and x5 have same inputs, and x2 and x6 have same inputs, and x3 and x7 have same inputs. Here x0 is obtained by multiplying xo of 0 with w8 of 0, and that term we are going to add with xc of 0. Similarly, x4 is obtained by multiplying xo of 0 with w8 0. That term we subtract from xc of 0. So this operation, entire operation, can be written in this format. This is called as a butterfly diagram. So here it is xo of 0 and this is xc of 0. So it is going up, this arrow is going up. So this is output is xe of 0 plus w8 0 xo 0. And this term is nothing but our x of 0. And here what we are going to do is that we are going to subtract w80 multiplied by x0. We are going to subtract this from xc of 0, and this term is nothing but x4. Understand this. Now if I have to draw this in general, I can construct a butterfly diagram for k takes the values from 1 to 7. It can be drawn something like this. Now if we'll further, if we'll decompose this, that is each n by 2 samples, if we'll further decompose, suppose that the even and odd part which we consider, further if we'll divide into, say, in two groups, and that can be expressed as following. So let's first consider the part of xck. So if I'll decompose this, for k is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to n by 2 minus 1. For this, if I'll write xck as xee k plus wn 2k xeo, that is the odd part of this even k, and this can be written as xee k minus n by 4. Now again we are dividing, so instead of n by 2, it is coming out to be n by 4 minus wn 2k minus n by 4 into xeo k minus n by 4. Here xek is n by 4 point DFT of, as you can see over here, of the even number of x e n. Okay, for this, okay, we are considering this. And x e o, this part, x e o k is n by 4 point of point DFT of the odd part of x e n. Okay, so this is for even part and this is for odd part of same x e n. Okay, so like this we had actually divided it. So, and for odd, similarly we can write it like x o k is equal to x o e k plus w n 2 k x o o, right? Odd part of odd, this is even part of odd of x o o k. For now, the k will take the values, k is greater than equal to 0 and k is less than or equal to n by 2 minus 1. So k is having the values in between, and this further, this can be written as x o e k minus n by 4 minus w n 2 k minus n by 4 into x o o k minus n by 4. Here k will take the values, n by 4 is less than or equal to k and is less than or equal to n by 2 minus 1. Here also k will take the value in this equation, it will take the values like this, n by 4 is less than or equal to k, which is less than or equal to n by 2 minus 1. Okay, so if we'll compare to earlier, where as here you can see that k was taking the values from n by 2 to n minus 1, right? And here it is taking the values n by 4 to n by 2 minus 1, right? So similar thing we are doing, which we did last time. Let's calculate the values for n is equal to 8. So as we are divided into the even and odd, again we are going to divide even part in the even and the odd part in the odd. So xee of 0, which is xe of 0, and xee of 1, which is actually xe of 2, xe of o of 0 is xe of 1, and xe o of 1 is equal to xe of 3, right? Now the equation which we saw over here, this equation, okay, from this equation what we can write as xe 0 is equal to xee 0 plus w 8 0 of xeo 0. Xe of 1 is equal to xee of 1 plus w 8 2 xeo 1, and xe of 2 can be written as xee 0 minus w 8 0 xeo 0, and xe of 3 is equal to xee 1 minus w 8 2 of xeo 1. Okay, so next part we are going to write for the odd one, right? So x o e of 0 can be it is equal to so x o 0 and x o e 1 is equal to x o 2. X o o 0 is equal to x o 1. X o o 1 is equal to x 0 3. Okay, and by this equation, the second equation which we have written, by that equation we can write as x 0 x o of 0 as x o e 0 plus w 8 0 x o o 0 x 0 1 is equal to x o e 1 plus w 8 2 x o o 1, and x o 2 is equal to x o e 0 minus w 8 0 x o o 0. X o 3 is equal to x o e 1 minus w 8 2 x o o 1. Now this can be drawn as following. Now now further, for 8-point DFT, number of stages we required are 3, right? So the third stage was given by this, second stage is given by this, and for the first stage, 2-point DFT can easily found, right? Just what we need to do is that we need to add and subtract. Why it is so? Because the Tweedle factor W80 is going to be 1 in this case. So all this W82 and whatever W83, W2, whatever we are going doing, there will not be anything like that, Okay, so it is just a 1. So there will not be any multiplication which was involved in this third and the second stage. In the first stage, it is just an subtraction and multiplication. Let's see how it is. So it is something like this: x e e 0 is x e e 0 plus x e e 1, and that is also going to be equal to x e 0 plus x e 2. Also, this is going to be equal to actually x 0 plus x 4, right? And for x e e 1, that is going to be x e e 0 minus x e e 1. This is going to be equal to x e 0 minus x e 2, which is actually going to be equal to x 0 minus x 4, right? So it is something like this. So that we can do for others also, that is x2, x6, x1 and x5 and x3 and x7, and it will generally will look like something like this. So this is the entire algorithm. I tried to use different color just to the sense of having the different lines. Again, I had written the Tweedle factors for each stage. The output is capital X, that is, this is in the frequency domain and this is in the time domain. Now here you can see that the input signal is bit reverse. This is called as a decimation in time because we actually divide the signal in smaller parts, right? So the input signal is decimated. Thank you, everyone.